In this calculus tutorial, I will show you guys how to use the chain rule one time to find the derivative. And here, we will also need to know the derivatives of all the trig functions. For sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. And if you want some tips on how to remember these derivatives, you can check out the video in the description. All right, so let's get started. We have sine of x squared. So this is really like saying sine of an input function like this, so sine of a box. We differentiate the sine function first, that's the outer function. And the derivative of sine is cosine. Remember, sine and cosine are best friends in calculus. And the box stays, and you just write down that x squared. And then we multiply by the derivative of the inside of the box. Derivative of x squared is 2x, just like that. And for this, let me just write down the calculus steps. Because the final step is you actually write this at the front, but let's not spend the energy on that. Let's just focus on the calculus derivative, especially with the chain rule. So that will be it. Now for the second one, we differentiate square root of cosine x. As we can see, the cosine x is the inner function, it's the inside of the box. So we first differentiate the square root, and that is something that you should remember as well. We get 1 over 2 square root. And then just put whatever inside of the box in here, which is cosine x. And then we will have to multiply by the derivative of this. Derivative of cosine, well, because we have a cofunction, so we have negative. And then sine and cosine are best friend, right? So the derivative of cosine is sine x, but negative because of that. And let's put down parentheses. Right, so that's it. Next, we are going to differentiate tangent to the fourth power x. And this really is saying that we have tangent x inside and then to the fourth power. Usually you can write it as a parenthesis, tangent x inside to the fourth power. So we actually have to use the power rule first. Bring the 4 to the front, and then minus 1, so we get 3. And this right here stays, we have that tangent x. Then we multiply by the derivative of tangent, and tangent and secant are best friends. The derivative of tangent is secant, and remember it has that square, so secant square x. Done. Okay. All right, for number 4, we are going to differentiate e to the cosecant x. So it's e to the box like this. The derivative of e to the box is just e to the box. So it's just e to the same thing, just stays like that. And then the derivative of cosecant x is, well, it's a cofunction, so it's negative derivative. For cosecant, the derivative first e repeats, and its best friend also has to be here. The best friend for cosecant is cotangent. Done. So just like that. Next, we have secant of square root of x. So this is kind of like the opposite, because this time, the square root function is the inside. So we will first have to differentiate the secant. The derivative secant is secant of the inside times tangent of the inside. This secant repeats first, and then you just maintain the inside here, and you also multiply by tangent of the inside. The box goes into both of the inside. The derivative of secant is secant and tangent. Just like the derivative of cosecant is cosecant and cotangent. Very similar. And remember, the cofunction has negative derivative. And then the last part is we differentiate the square root, which is 1 over 2 square root of x. Just like that. Lastly, we are going to differentiate cotangent of 3x. So this is the inner function. Derivative of cotangent, cofunction, we have negative derivative. Cotangent and cosecant are best friends. This right here is cosecant squared. Just like tangent is secant squared, right? Cotangent, we have cosecant squared. But cofunction, we have negative derivative. Inner function stays, so just write that down. And then we multiply by the derivative of the inside. It's just going to be a 3. Just like that. So hopefully this right here helps, and check out my next video because I will show you guys how to use the chain rule twice. Check it out.